some of the other decisions you have to make when you're a mom, and it's really weird, and it's just a lot of pressure to make the right choice. And the problem is that everything is marketed so that every choice might kill your child. If you circumcise him, he might bleed out. When no one's paying attention, I suppose. And if you don't circumcise him, he could get a MRSA infection that kills him. And you're like, what? I don't know. What are you guys talking about? It's just crazy. Like, have you guys heard of secondary drowning?
Yes.
Okay, this is his thing. Yes. When I was a child and I grew up on the beach in Virginia, I would swallow half my weight in seawater every damn day of the summer. And somehow wake up the next morning, but some poor child, and this is horrific, died when they went swimming, seemed okay, went to sleep and never woke up. And I get that those parents feel the need to make sure they educate everyone possible that that could happen to your child. But what actually happens is now nobody is sleeping. And nobody's swimming because you're all freaked out about it. And then now there's all this weird new pressure. Have you guys heard this one? They want you to eat your placenta? Yeah. Yes. It would be one thing if after giving birth to your child, you did a Khaleesi style and went, roar! And just ate it. And we all went, yes, 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 X, X. That would be like an awesome party trick. You'd have frat guys come to your room and be like, you gonna watch her eat the placenta? It's awesome. Girl's a badass. She fell out of her vagina. She's gonna eat it. There's nothing that has ever fallen out of my body that hasn't cried that I've ever wanted to go back to or eat. And they're like, oh, it makes a difference. How do you know? Because you don't have a control of that experiment, right? Like, it completes the experience. Yeah, when I eat a lobster at a restaurant, I don't look at the shell and go, I should complete that experience. If I was a real woman, I would eat the shell. And there's Pinterest pages on umbilical cord crafts. Have you guys seen this? You can make it into a heart and then dry it out and hang him over his crib. Well, that just seems a little bit satanic to me. That don't seem quite right. And then when you die, what the hell is your kid gonna do when they're cleaning out your house? Okay, this is something we should never have. Can you donate that? I don't, what? Oh gosh. And then the weird thing about placenta is it's not that they eat it raw after your birth. We encapsulate it in little tiny pills. And I don't know who does that. I think it's the same people that make meth in their basement. Like have a side gig. I don't understand. There's no like FDA regulations. Is that even your placenta? It's creepy. Thank you. It was correct. That is a correct response. I'm also breastfeeding my son, and we're still breastfeeding. We're at the end of breastfeeding. Yeah, thank you for that one. And that's weird, because that is controversial, too, because people are weird about breastfeeding. They're like, well, once he can start saying, you know, that he needs some milk, you can't give it to him anymore. He's too big for it. That makes no sense. As soon as he says apple, do you go, well, now that you said it, you're not getting more apples. Nope, you're too big now. None. Here's the deal. You guys, milk drinkers, are drinking the milk of random cows you've never met. This is a free-range organic mommy right here. I know everything that went into that milk. It's not that weird. Worldwide, people breastfeed till 4, but we're still breastfeeding. It's not that weird of a deal. But I think it's an interesting relationship because people look at you a little funny when you're doing it. I oftentimes wonder, like, what kind of a son have I made? Because clearly we have some weird stuff in our background. I'm like, what kind of kid are you going to be? And so one day I was looking at him while he was breastfeeding. I thought, this is this magical motherhood moment people talk about. But then he pulled away from the boob and he puked all over me. And I went, ugh. And he looked at me and went, meh, and went in for more. I'm like, oh my God, you are going to be so good at college, buddy. She's covered in puke, but tits, yeah.